worry.
We'll make sure you're safe.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
Tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf Rey. But Rey
she has makeup.
Does not love the boy.
Look at that.
Instead,
look at that.
He plans
beautiful
to use
scar
for his own ends.
And then that blue shit on her face.
You see, Rayan's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rayan's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature.
What is it?
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
Don't go in. Don't.
Turn back.
What's
it?
Get
back. A great beast guards Helheim. Gorm is its name.
I think it's
and
fine.
It knows you are here, so
let's go in.
It can smell your stink.
What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadow?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Oh, fuck.
Don't be fooled. The beast is still here.
The beast.
To do. Your father wants them to go away, and he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they won't be with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen
to them.
Do you
see them? Do you see their faces?
She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started.
When her I have to look for these mind. Things in the fucking in the
her
room of the beast.
Past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach.
But
the
beast just doesn't chase now because I have a torch.
He said.
Alright.
It was a lot to take in for a child.
A beast.
And the first time she felt
a beast has
cold,
been here.
Chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zimbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
The light's gone out.
Oh, the beast!
Run, get Korea as quick as you can.
The beast!
Beast.
Game is fucking disturbing, man.
Look, the roots. Can you feel them?
Can you see them?
Come on, that's it, right? Right there. How is this not it? How is this not it? All right. All right, man. All right.
You have it. Keep going. What's next? Do you want to fight? I feel like you want to fight. Why are you doing these pointless things? Symbols are pointless. They're meaningless. Your mother's here. What if you collect them and there's nothing behind the door? Save Dillian. This is just another trial.
Rian the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells dragon. Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rian would forge a strong sword for him.
What? This game
Sigurd
is not
remembers
disturbing.
That his father once
I hear voices
sword
all the time.
Given to him by Odin.
I hear voices
Odin
broke
sometimes, the sword to bring
about like
Sigmund's
this.
Death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rian reforges the famous sword. The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it.
What the fuck? Where am I supposed to go?
Comes to all men, and every man will want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Respect women. Women. We all respect women here. Now. All of us here respect women now. What? Oh! Is that the beast? Ah, camera.
Behind you. Finish this. End it now. Behind you. Watch it.
Peace.
11 months. Samsung, thanks for the good times, bra.
Thanks, Mr. Lolita. I'm not saying that last part, you fuck.
She hasn't.
She did it. She's done it.
Well done. This place. It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night. The faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
I don't know where to go. Maybe even further back? Because I think it's the other side of this place, huh? Maybe. I think this is too far back. Huh? Yeah, this is too far back. That's the one down. Maybe it's a side area here. I think I missed something in here. Did I ever go? Oh, I don't think you can go anywhere from here. What about here? I can fix the stairs here or something? What's happening? Jesus. I don't think it's here at least. I must have missed an entrance somewhere. Maybe I missed something here. It's only that this thingy here. Is this a door or something? Surely it's somewhere here. Oh, this is... Oh my god, there's a second part. I didn't go this way yet. Can't see shit.
Her torch is going out. No, it's not.
What do you mean my torch is going out?
She's too slow.
What do you mean my torch is going out? It's perfectly fine. Later, beast!
That she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
It's a trap. The beast is coming.
The beast! Drop the torch, you stupid bitch!
lost him! It's over!
The darkness is back. We've lost him!
Without his head, you will never bring his soul back. His fate is sealed. Now it can see you at your weakest. The time you suffered as a child at the hands of your father Zimno while you pined for Dillion. Do you remember the darkness, Senua? The beast is bringing it back.
Me, John War.
You leave me. This darkness, it's spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others, away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillion.
Oh yeah, let's go all the way down there just to get some fucking heads. The beast torch, maybe? Oh my god, I almost left without this. It's that beast.
The beast is down there.
No. She knows the beast is down there. He's always watching you.
The beast is there. You're never safe from it.
You can feel it. She needs to find Dillion.
She lost it,
and she has to find it.
Can you watch out of this water or what? What happens? Huh? Oh! Why can't I stop time? Oh! The beast! My torch! Where is it? There! Oh, the beast. Oh. Fuck. That's the only thing that can kill me. That beast. Maybe not. Has to be here somewhere, right? It's probably some retarded angle. Maybe it's just down there. Maybe from below? Well, shit! Oh, the beast! Oh, that's too far! Never fight that beast.
He was trying to save her from the darkness.
Zinbel was right. Zinbel was trying to save her from the darkness.
Akuma was right.
But she wouldn't resist. And she's fit. And now everybody's dead because of her. It's all her fault. So weak. She should have known. She shouldn't have. Why doesn't she learn? She will she learn? She doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dillion's soul.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will not.
She's let her down before. The lights run out and took her out. She'll die.
She has to do it.
She can't.
Do I have to do it really fast or something? Let's look for it first before I go in. Because that beast is gonna come.
The darkness is and she'll die.
Fuck. What is it, like a... two of those arcs? Is there another torch on the other side? That's fucking scary. That's so fucking scary. Ah, fuck! Well, fuck! Lore time?
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd
There's
does
no way I can make this fit,
when
right?
He touches the roasted heart to see if it is done. He burns his finger. Without thinking,
or is it?
He licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood.
Is it pretty gross? Wait, can I go up here?
The language of birds and hears them talk.
Yeah, I think
nearby.
I need to light that one, but how? Probably have to run all the way across. Fuck it, man! YOLO! What can that beast really do to me? Alright, alright, alright. And! And!
Get up! Get up!
Oh! Alright. Alright, where next? Fuck! Where next? Fuck! Can I jump? No? Nope. Which way do I go? Left or right? Alright. I'm gonna go to the right side. And that doesn't count as light, huh? All of that doesn't count as light. I don't think I can light that one over there without having a light on. Do I go left side? Are you fucking shit? To go back. Stop. Why is this not on fire? Oh my God.
Where is she going? Faster, keep going. You can't get through. She has to do it. Force it. Get up. Get up. What are you doing? Where are you going? What's she doing?
She's lighting the torch. She's making light.
She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe.
Faster, faster, keep going, keep going.
What is she doing?
Stop.
Now
she's angry.
Stop.
Stop it.
Oh. I did pick it up. And
we will fight.
Come on, bruh. Oh, that arm does not look good right now. Oh no, it's going in the titties soon.
I can't help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach.
Oh, let's go in the hall. Yeah, let's go. From what let's go in the hall full of corpses.
When he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and
the
hears
beast
the
is near
nearby.
The beast?
Come back.
Keep that torch above water, you stupid bitch!
I'm coming for you!
Oh! Stupid bitch!
I'm coming!
The beast! The beast!
You're not taking it from me!
I warned you, Senua.
It's the beast.
I smell your
blood. No!
You betrayed your god.
I am leaving with him!
You turned your back on me. That is why Dillion will rot in hell. Call me to my shadow.
Not a bad idea. All right. What?
This blood.
Harry. Oh. Ah. Up, 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 slut. Where's the light? Focus. It's not get the light, the fucking voice has lied to me. What? That hit me?
She's injured. She can still do it.
The beast! What? The beast! Tamed the beast. Oh, that's like some... I think there's a meteor. Oh, the beast!
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel.
Is that a pixelated thing over there?
Rituals kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore. But believe this, it was my mission to make you hate, to hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. But without it, I fear that you would have let those slack. All this time, I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve.
Oh shit, man, that arm doesn't look good at all. Look, it's at my neck! What's that, two more deaths?
I won't stand in your way. You will not survive what is in there.
Mother, I won't let the darkness trick me again. I know you're safe with the gods. I can feel Hela's gaze searching for secrets inside of me. Secrets that even I can't see. I'm not here to fight my past. I'm here for Delian. I will fulfill my vow, whatever the cost.
fix that beast.
This isn't just a broken bridge, is it? Mother, you showed me how to see further. To see the hidden wonders in our world and explore new paths into the unknown. To lead so that others may follow, or to warn so that they may avoid. That is our gift and our duty. I'm not going to look away in fear anymore.
She's so special. She's so
special.
She must see. She has the sight. She can see their secrets.
That's jumpable, right? Okay, maybe not.
The Northmen say the world will come to an end.
They call no it strength.
Ragnarok. The destiny of the gods. First, there will be a terrible winter, 3 years long. Then, mankind will turn on itself. Brothers will fight each other to the death, and people will forget what they owe their kindred. Times will be hard. Crimes will be great. It will be an age of axes and swords. The wind will blow through abandoned halls. Wolves will walk where children played. The world will fall into ruin.
Thank fuck I didn't get stuck there. Thank fuck. I was so close to flaming the shit out of this game.
The Northmen say the gods will fight their last battle at Ragnarok. Their watchmen will blow the horn that can be heard through the whole world. And
Ragnarok.
Odin will speak with the severed
man.
Head of Mimir.
What happened to that game?
The land of the giants will thunder with the sound of their army on the moon. The gods will assemble, the dwarves will leave their stones, the frost giants will come from the east, the Midgard serpent will turn up the waves, eagles will scream and tear at the corpses with their yellow beaks, the ship of the dead will set sail.
This guy needs to chill. I wasn't ready. Ah, fuck it. No puns, dude, come on! Not now! It's not the time! Now is not the time for puns, son.
How will she do it? What will she do?
Alright, time to read what the pun was. Hey ding dong, my doctor's office has two doctors on call at all times. Is that considered a pair of box. Paradox.
How many worlds have you played this already?
How many hours have I played already? 5 hours, man. I think I'm close to the end.
No one can bargain with Helen. What does Helen want? What can she give her?
I hate puns so much. Alright, I kind of don't know where to go for the last part because I've been everywhere now, haven't I? Or maybe something opened up on the bridge itself?
A cursed soul.
Can I go here?
Of course she is, no matter what she does. She can fight her. She can fight her at Ragnarok.
Or is it just fixed? Is the bridge fixed? No, that fucking, that's floating pieces of bridge. Look at that shit.
Her soul is valuable. Hella. She can take Dillian's soul.
Open maybe?
Him to rest. Hella.
Fuck!
She can get his soul back.
Do I have to go further back?
She's so close.
Was it maybe here that I didn't do it?
She can do it. She just has to be prepared to fight for it.
Oh, it's definitely on that side. Somewhere up there.
What if she falls at the final hurdle? She won't.
Maybe then I missed Helen a door here?
Both their souls. She will defeat Helen's all for nothing.
There's a door
she
here.
Doesn't save
I didn't.
Soul will be eternally bound. No. Stay here forever. Being tortured. No. No. She's stuck. Helen. She will join Dillian. What happens to Senua?
The darkness will take her anyway.